this country, it is at high time that we came to realization that this country belongs to all of us. And I'm worried. I've seen Kenyans being quiet at an opportune time when the country is trying to inform our next constitution. And it is very clear that the constitution is changing in early next year. So our first is, I would urge all Kenyans to come out and participate in this without fear, without feeling intimidated. And there are some things we need to look into as we go on with the process. First is the views of every citizen should be included. Secondly is the administration of the process. The decision-making process is a people, should be a people-driven process, not a leaders or a political class-driven process. And what I would say about giving our views is, first I'll go back to where I'm elected from, in Kitui County. It is very clear that Kitui County is the second largest county in Kenya after Kakamega. And what we've seen recently with the final proposals from the BBI, which was unveiled in Bomas of Kenya, Kitui County got no extra administrative or political unit. We never got an extra constituency. Mwingi County, Mwingi was there as a county in the 2010 constitution. It was removed in the last minute. So what we are saying is, the BBI report, the task force, should include Mwingi County in what is going to be approved by the country as our next constitution. Mwingi County has to be there as a county receiving its resources as a unit of devolution in this country. Secondly, Kitui needs an extra constituency. Kitui County is bigger than both Makueni and Machakos County combined. And Makueni and Machakos County combined, they've gotten three extra constituencies. So how do we leave out Kitui County without an extra constituency? So we are also looking and urging, and we've given our proposals, that Kitui County should get an extra constituency in the name of Kitui Municipal Constituency. Secondly, you look at Kitui County is bigger in terms of land, in terms of population, than the three counties of Northeastern, Garissa, Mandera, Wajir. Kitui County is bigger than Garissa, Mandera, and Wajir. And they are all units of devolution. They are all counties receiving their own share from the national government. Then how comes we say that BBI is good for the country when Kitui remains so huge in terms of landmass and population, and no extra unit, that means no extra resources to Kitui County? Another thing about Kitui County we want to talk about is the Moi Coal Basin is in Kitui County. It is cutting across three constituencies: the constituency of Kitui South, the constituency of Kitui East, the constituency of Mwingi Central. It's cutting across four sub-counties. What does that mean? It means if coal mining in Kenya is allowed, it means people from those four sub-counties will be affected by this law. So in the BBI report, it should be very clear that the country is going to outlaw, Kenya should outlaw coal mining in our country through the BBI report. And that will sort out the whole mess of people living in fear of being moved from their land, or people being affected by environmental hazards when coal is being mined. Failure to which the BBI report will find serious handles with our people in Kitui, and especially the rural Kitui, because that's where Moi Basin, the Moi Coal Basin is. The other thing we are looking at is now the process. We've had an independent task force receiving reports from Mwananchi, receiving views from interest groups, receiving views from economic regions. But after the report which was unveiled by the president in Bomas the other day, a trade has crept now where when you want, first is the BBI reports that it was unveiled by the president cannot be opened. The president was very clear that he's given an opportunity and is going to appoint a more central chief to incorporate the new ideas and whatever ideas Mwananchi is bringing forth, whatever interested groups, county governors, all these groups are bringing for inclusion in the BBI report, what Kitui County is bringing. And we are very, very happy with the president opening that up, that window. for that will give us an uncontested an opportunity to create a consensus which will lead to an uncontested referendum. So what we are looking at is after the president had given that window of opening up the BBI report for more discussion and building of consensus, Raila Odinga has gone ahead and said the BBI report cannot accommodate any further interest from another group. I think that should be stopped. We've also seen a trend that interest groups, communities, economic blocks, if you want, after the president said he's going to build consensus and allow more reports to the BBI, we've seen groups being forced, instead of taking your requirements, instead of taking your proposals to the independent task force, you are being forced to take your proposals to Raila Odinga. For heaven's sake, this calls for interpretation by the court. And if Raila Odinga, we as the president would stop Raila Odinga from acting as a broker between Kenyans and the constitution making process. We can't allow Raila Odinga to be the broker between interested groups, communities, and how their reports, how their input gets to the BBI report. That cannot be allowed. So we are approaching it in two ways. First is president should stop Raila Odinga from doing that, because that also contrary to what the president said. The other thing is we'll be going to court to get an interpretation, and the court, first thing, will pray to court to stop the constitution making process happening in this country currently until that time Raila Odinga stops from receiving reports from Mwananchi, unlike where reports should not be taken directly to the independent task force. And those, all these flaws, all these irregularities which has been committed in the process of coming up with the referendum bill and the referendum question will be put into task when we head to court later this week, because we will not allow a process that is made to affect the lives of our children long after we are gone to be possessed, to be taken up by one individual and ruin the whole thing. I have decided with a few leaders in this country, and especially from Kitui, we are going to court later this week, by the end of this week. Raila, it will be the constitution, the courts have to pronounce themselves in the matter of how the process is being carried. Because why should we have a broker between the independent team that is receiving views and Mwananchi? Every Mwananchi needs to be allowed to go directly to the independent team and voice their ideas and their opinions, and the independent team is the one which is to say the way it looks, the way president has said it, let's open up this, and now we move towards bringing in more ideas and building consensus, not one individual.